Canals can be a dangerous drowning hazard in Fresno County. Although the surface of the water may seem calm, the current and often debris below can become deadly quick. Community Regional Injury Prevention Outreach Specialist Eliana Troncalli shares what you and your family can do to stay safe around canals.
We have lots of canals, lots of ditches, ponding basins. They're all used to supply a very valuable resource, water.
With temperatures rising in the valley, some people think it's okay to quickly jump into that water when it's not.
So we have seen instances where people just intend to just cool off in a canal that appears to be calm water. But what is misleading about canals is that they may appear to be calm on the surface, but there may actually be a swift undercurrent with fast moving water. There's also trash and debris under there that you can get stuck in. And then it's also deeper than you might think. You might see ladders around there, but they're not intended to climb in and out of canals with. Those are for maintenance workers.
Eliana says even if you don't plan on going for a swim, use caution when around the bank of a canal.
They may have a trail on the side of them, so use those designated trails. Don't use the canal banks for recreational activities. If your property backs up to one or you're by one, have a boundary, have a fence.
If you come across someone in danger and in a canal, act swiftly by calling 911.
The last thing you want to do is get in and now you're risking your life. And rescuers are going to have two people to save instead of one person. And try to get the person that's in the canal to try to get them to float on their back. If you have something that you can throw to them that's a flotation device, or if you have something that they can use to get themselves out, that would be best.
The Central Valley heat can feel overwhelming at times. So if you feel yourself needing a moment to cool off, Eliana recommends finding a cooling center to retreat to.
In the city of Fresno, there's recreational centers, activity centers, also commercial centers like malls. There's designating cooling centers with extended hours, and every city, town has them.
That's all for this week's episode of MedWatch Today. Please join us next week for more inspiring stories from Community Health System. I'm Amberlynn Carroll. Thank you.